so I recently posted this video on my channel which was about how I click my own pictures for Instagram, and so many of you just loved that video and thank you so much for that. And a lot of you in the comment section also told me that I should make a video on how I edit those pictures. So yeah, today we are doing that and let's just get into the video. So today I'll be showing you the editing of two pictures. One is shot indoor and one is shot outdoor. So first image looks like this, and this one is shot outdoor, so I'm just gonna go and share this one to Snapseed. Now Snapseed is the only editing app which I use for all the pictures because it's too much work, right? And this app is like really good because it has almost everything which I personally need. So yeah, there are some things, like basic things, which I do on every image. So the first thing which I always do whenever I import a picture on Snapseed is I always, you know, increase its sharpness. Now how you can find the sharpness tool is you can go to tools, then details, and yeah, here's a sharpening tool. You can increase or decrease, and there's no particular number that I follow. I just, you know, play with it and see whatever pleases my eye. So I think, yeah, 42 looks fine. And there's also this structure tool. Now what it does is that if you decrease the structure, it kind of like smoothens the whole background, the skin, but I don't use it a lot, so I think 0 it is. Yeah, so only sharpening. And the next thing which I do is I always add some pink tint on my images. Now you can find that in white balance, and here's this tint. Now if you increase the tint, there's this pink and purplish, and if you go to the left side, it's green and more green. So I add like 5 or 6, 7, I think this much is fine. I mean, no particular number, you can just play around with it and see like how you want to convey the mood of your picture. And yeah, these are the two things which I do on every image, sharpening and, you know, give some pink tint to it. And now you can just play with your images. So next thing I do is I play with this grainy film. It gives that old retro vintage sort of effect which I really like. So I'm going to do this grainy film thing, and there are a lot of filters going on, and yeah, you can just play. Oh, I really like this one, X01. I mean, I like this one on this particular picture. Otherwise I just play around with it, and the style is, you can increase or decrease. I think I like 50. 50 is like not too much, not too less. And grainy is like, if I increase the grain, you can actually see the result, and if I decrease it, so yeah, you can like choose accordingly. I think 30 is fine for this one. So yeah, and if you touch your picture like this, you can see the result like this. So different. But as you can see that I haven't touched my face at all. And next thing you can play around with is the vintage filter. Now vintage again comes with a lot of filters. You can again play around with it and see what suits your picture. I like this one, 12, last number, because it gives it like a film mood. So again, you can increase or decrease its style, saturation. In this particular picture, I do not want to increase the brightness because I feel like it gives the whole mood of, you know, relaxed and calm vibe. Now, vignette is something which can like change the mood of your whole picture. If you vignette is basically the borders. If you want to add the darker borders or, you know, white borders like this, like shadows from the borders. I don't know how to explain this one. So yeah, I think this 23 is fine. And yeah, I just like this picture. I don't think I need to do a lot with this. And again, if you just click this picture and hold, this is the original image and this is the edited image, which I really like. And then yeah, you can just share it on Instagram or wherever you like. Feed, what should I write? Okay, I'm just gonna save it with my favorite smileys, which is heart, flower, fire, hands, and this and star. I have so many favorite smileys and I'm just gonna save it. Cool! And now let's edit our second picture, which was shot indoors, and Bhavna clicked this picture. Thank you so much, Bhavna. And yeah, again, I'm just going to share it on Snapseed. I got cold again. What's up with me? And again, tools, details, sharpen it. I mean, these are the basic things which I do. I mean, again. And white balance, give it some pink tint. I think this one is fine, 11. Yeah. And now again, if you touch and hold, you can see the green tint. I believe that whenever I click the picture from this phone, it has some yellow or green tint to it. So yeah, that is the only reason why I give it some pink tint. But now I give it to every picture of mine because I just like it. So yeah. And again, I'm just going to play with grainy film. No, I am not using X01 which we used in the first picture because I think this is not suited for this particular picture. So yeah, just going to play around with it. I think L03 looks nice because I think it goes with the background of the picture. And yeah, grain, I think 20 is fine. I think style strength is 100 and grain 0. I do not want to add any grain to it. Now, if you hold the image, this is the original image and this is the edited image. And I have just added this filter, like you can see my acne spots here and there. Just do not touch your face. I mean, if you want to, you can, but I do not. So yeah. And now I wanted to show you one thing, one crazy thing you can do with your images. You can go to this double exposure, right, like on the left hand side of the text, double exposure, and you can choose any image. It kind of like overlaps the image and you can like adjust it accordingly. I think this is the really crazy thing which you can do if you're shooting outdoors in night. So yeah, this is just the one thing which I wanted to share. I'm not going to use it in this one. And I think this picture looks a bit teddy. So I'm just going to correct it by rotate like this. Yeah, I think this looks fine. And I don't think I have to do anything else with that. Alright, one more thing I would like to share with you all is that as you can see, this part is a bit black. Not that black, but a bit black. So you can use this selective tool and touch this and you know increase its brightness or reduce its brightness. But as you can see, while I am increasing its brightness, it also plays with the brightness of my face. Can you see that? So what you can do is that you can pinch it and reduce its circle, and yeah, you can just increase the brightness of only that particular area. Yeah, it will look like this. And again, here also, yeah, now it looks fine. So I think this looks fine according to me. I mean, yeah, and then again you can just share it on Instagram or wherever you like, feed. How much? And you can also increase the sharpness here as well if you feel like. Sharp pictures is something which I really like. I mean, smooth or soft pictures or blurred pictures are fine unless they are conveying a mood or you know portraying a message, but otherwise I like sharp images. And yeah, that's it. That's how it looks. So yeah, this is how just I edit my Instagram pictures, and these are the basic things which are applicable on every picture of mine on Instagram unless those are the pictures which are clicked by any photographer. I mean, those pictures I just do not retouch, re-edit or even sharpen because I think that picture shows that photographer's perspective and creativity, and I just do not want to ruin that, and I really respect their hard work. Anyway, I just hope that you enjoyed watching this video, and if you try these things which I do on my pictures, then do send me the pictures on my Instagram handle, which is hervagabondlife. And thank you so much for the last time as well. I posted every story you guys sent me on my stories, and this time also I'll do that. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.